So today is supposed to be my rest day. But really, what's going to happen is I'm going to the doctor. Squeezing the barbell has been crazy. Like, crazy. But all right, y'all. Let me get out of here. I don't like making these joints too long because I record on my phone and it's not like an SD card I can slide into the computer. See you in a bit. All right, so excuse the glasses, y'all. Maybe sliding all over the place because I gotta wear this mask. But the rules are the rules. Is that how you say it? The rules are the rules. Just waiting. We'll see what happens. Now. Oh, and the doc is here.
Mr. Cooper?
Yes, hi. Sorry, we're back. Reset. Thank you. Fuck. Found it in a strongman bunker somewhere in like Colorado or something. Yeah, I can't be turned to no strong zombie, you feel me?
Look, I ain't even start working out yet. You see what you're doing to me, Brian? You see what you're doing to me? Thank you. Thank you.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 30. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 40. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 50.
They ain't get five. I got three.
Yep. I can't get a word in edgeways. Talk, talk, talk. But no wonder you're not sharp. You've got to always
Shut up!
Yeah, so I just got off the phone with my doctor, and she got the x-rays, and she just said to me, though, Dad, in fact, it is definitely a fracture. In fact, I can't even move my freaking finger, really. Like, I can, but look at it. Yo, that's crazy. That don't even look like my finger. Like, that's crazy. You feel me? Like, yo, that's crazy. That's crazy. Look. Look at that. Again. Look. Look at the finger. That's crazy. You have no idea. And I'm sitting here like, yo, I can't deadlift the way I want to deadlift. I can't do certain lifts the way I want to do it. I'm doing it. But she just told me, like, yo, chill out, fall back. schedule your appointment so you can get that fixed. But I really can't deadlift. Like, I'm really, like, I'm holding it, the bar, and when I'm holding, let me see. Because I can really get this down here. The problem is that I can't close it at all. So, it's getting better. I don't know. Actually, it's been feeling better since I've been taking this college and stuff. But, yeah. But I can't close it. That's it. Look, you see how it is? I can't. Nothing. That's the shrimp. It's the shrimp scampi. I can't close it. It's funny. Funny. Oh, well. It is what it is. And I'll get back to it. But, whatever. I knew I wasn't bugging.
Come on, let's go. Looks like we're gonna be here for a while, ladies and gentlemen. Struggled, man. Fuck. Can't lie to y'all. Hold on. I can't lie to you. Dude. This shit hurts. Like, it hurts. What am I like? 4:30. The more the weight goes up, it's crazy. It's like my finger is screaming at me. Like, it's cursing at me. It's telling me, fuck you. It hurts. I'm mad. Yeah. So now, so you know what happened. This finger just won't, it gets like frozen. It just get mad stiff. Pissing me off, man. Pissing me off. Whatever.
Brace.
It's on fire. You see that? Freaking hand is mad stiff. Thing is, it's just shaking, like trembling. All right, cool, so I had to open up a new pair of tins that I ordered from Silver Spring. They're kind of fresh. I mean fresh. They're fresh. Look, fresh. They look good. They're solid. You know, most people ask me why I don't use bumper plates. I used to. I used to use them a lot. But I can't lie to you. This pig iron is way heavier. It's crazy.
Listen, that wind gust out there is crazy. It was waking me up. Like one of them old cartoons, or you know, when you read your old school books as a kid and they talk about how the wind and the trees and how it was blowing and withering and the wind and the air and the and dude, it is crazy out there. I definitely need those new glasses that I ordered. But yeah, I'm gonna get out of here. I stepped out there just for like 1 second. My phone almost flew out my hand. The door was swinging crazy. It was about to knock it out my hand. It's time to go. I'm gonna throw on some Resident Evil 3 and go watch that until the night, you know, ends. Hopefully I don't have no nightmares from it. All right, y'all, peace.
$225 for 6 reps. Fifth rep was horrible. $240 for 3 to 5 reps. Two sets. All right, personal record, 265. Kind of sloppy.
Long run. This is not a sprint. I am not sprinting to get there fast. However, I am not working too slow. I'm still doing what I have to do, and I'm not gonna stop doing what I have to do. You know, I recently had a dude, he interviewed me. I think his name is Max Hall. Yeah, Max Hall. He has a YouTube channel. Yeah, any athlete that likes anime, he basically interviews. And one of the things and one of the topics that he talked about was being humble. And I'm not gonna lie to you, just like what I said to him, I don't claim to be humble. I'm not gonna claim to be humble. And the reason why I'm not gonna claim to be humble is because it's not a title that you can claim. It's a title that someone has to give you. And by all means, lifting these sandbags, these Atlas stones, all the weights that we lift, you can't be humble. But here's the thing, the weight is supposed to humble you. I hope that makes sense to you or anybody that's out there that's watching this. I really hope that makes sense to you. So, I don't claim to be humble because you can't just be humbled to lift these weights, to lift these sandbags, to move an Atlas stone, to get an axle bar up to your chest, you know, to do a cross carry, to, you know, farmer walks. The list goes on. You know, you can't be humble while you're pulling this car in your back. You gotta actually bleed. You gotta bleed while you're doing it. There's no being humble when doing this. Even powerlifting. There's no being humble. None of the athletes that's out there busting their hump is being humble. They can't be humble. They get humbled by the weights. They get humbled by the work. I shouldn't have this as an injury, you know? Or maybe I should. Maybe I should have it as an injury. Maybe that is the experience that I needed to know though that it's gonna get worse. And it can get worse. But are you willing to sacrifice and to still chase after a dream or a goal, you know, that you really believe in? You believe you can do this. You've been doing this for a while. You might not have been out here competing. You might not have been in every underground gym that's out there, but you've been here. In fact, you've just been like a hidden gem, just around. And because you didn't have nobody or no knowledge on things, and all you've been doing is just Googling everything and YouTubing and picking up books and doing your homework. Dude, you've just been here the whole time. But no one knew about you. And it's just weird for some guy to just come out of nowhere like, hey, I'm a strong man. Well, they did it back then before us. Guess what? I'm doing it now. I'm a strong man. People go, oh, you make hip-hop music. Why don't you stick to that? Of course I'm gonna make hip-hop music. That's what I do. That's my art. That's what I do in my free time. What else I do in my free time? I like watching people beat the games because I'm not gonna waste my time to beat them. Why? Because I'm sitting in the garage trying to learn how to be the best strong man that I could be. So on the days that I need to rest, my rest days, and I tell myself, yo, it is rest day for a reason. Foam roll, do some ab work, go for a walk. It's been bad over here. It's real icy out here. And not only just that, I gotta go pick up a crazy shovel because my shovel just broke on me. Bad. Real bad. I'm really trying to get used to this rest day stuff more and more and more because, to be honest with you, if it was up to me, I'd be working out more than what I've been working out recently. And I've been doing a great job telling myself, yo, you only have an hour and a half to do your work. If you can't get it all done, it moves the next day into the next workout. So you better do it now. If not, your off days, it's gonna move into your off time. And now in your off time, you gotta finish up a workout that you didn't get to finish up. You didn't get to wrap it up. So I'm basically being like one of the head monks inside of Shaolin Temple. And they're like, you must do all your chores, young man. If you don't do all your chores, then you won't be able to eat. What? I won't be able to eat? That's right. You won't be able to eat. What? Yeah. Be one of them guys. Be my own monk. Because I ain't got a monk. And therefore, I gotta be a student and a teacher. Or the teacher and the student. And this whole programming stuff, I want to learn it. I want to do it on my own. I'm gonna get it on my own. I'll look at other samples or other ideas of what people are doing. And to be honest with you, it's like, I'm looking for something that really works with me, that I feel dope works with me, and I like. Other than that, I'm can't lie. I've been out here on my own, bro. And don't get it twisted, I'm good with everyone. It's just still that I got tired of always feeling like I was asking for help or asking too much questions. And some people answer, and
you know, others, it just didn't feel like it came off that way, you know? It didn't feel like I was meant to really ask them that. They, like, I don't know, probably, like, belittling me, you know, or making me feel small. I hate people like that. That's right, I said it. I hate people like that. Yeah, I just don't make people feel small. Especially if they ask me a question. If I know the answer, I give you the answer. I don't have to give you my technique, though. You know? Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. But I can answer the question. And I can also answer the question without being a dickhead. If that makes any sense. But I bumped into that a lot. And another thing that we talked about in the interview was those that, hey, yeah, people show love and people, they reach out and they got this whole brotherhood. That's right. But that doesn't apply for everyone. Not everybody actually wants to talk to you. You know, not everybody wants to be your friend. And that's something, though, that I'm A-okay with, too. And that being said, it's like, I'm not forcing people to like me, to conversate with me, to talk to me, or whatever. Be in your group, be in your circle, do what you do, whatever. I ain't got time for it, because I got to keep focusing on me. And by all means, an athlete's focus should be on himself. Can't be out here focusing on the world. And with that being said, that's why I'm cutting back on filming a bunch of video clips for Instagram. I feel like where I want to be at is YouTube, and that's my outlet. Yeah, Instagram is cool. I think I'll film that single PR for those people that just want to see me do a PR or what am I doing recently. Probably film a few PRs for the week and throw it in there on Instagram. But I don't want to be sitting there making it my whole focus, taking me off track while I'm trying to actually work out. You know, I'm actually trying to do what I have to do. And it's not like I got a buddy or a friend to hold the camera for me and then going to set up the freaking camera back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and seeing if I'm standing there. And then if you don't know, your front camera is not as good as your back camera. So that's another issue, because now it's like, dang, I need to see it from the front in order for me to look good. And then if I don't do it from the front, then I can't see what's going on in front of the, you know, on the camera, because we're using a back camera, which is in 4K, and now it's like I gotta go run all the way over there to make sure that I'm lined up correctly, because I'm not sharp enough. It's just so many moving parts that it's like, this is why I hired someone to come and shoot my footage for me when I do my comps, because I can't shoot my own comps. I couldn't even shoot my own footage for myself at the pit, you know, when I did that comp. And I tried to look for some salvage footage. I tried to even get some footage from one of the other dudes that was there, but that ain't go so well. And it was just like, yo, I just need to know, though, that I have a reliable cameraman when the day comes. And that has been a success so far. But yeah, the pandemic is kicking in hard. And we just got a new COVID-19 virus that just came out. I think they said it hit London or something like that. Something like that. My wife was talking about it. And I was like, what? You know, I'm just so tired and fed up of all this. Like, leave me alone. Like, get out my face, COVID. I'm tired of you. I'm tired of you. You gotta go, man. Like, leave already. Leave. Nobody got no more time for you. You got to go. Pack your bags and leave. Please. Please. Freaking tired. Gotta go outside every day. Got me out here with mask on, like. Now I know how Jim Carrey feel. Ridiculous. I got tired of paper masks. They break right on me. And I know if I was at the comp, I would have had to use a whole pack, because I was sweating. And when I sweat, it's bad, you know? I know y'all seen me sweating in some of them videos on this channel. So I ain't even gonna sit here and act like I don't be sweating. I be sweating. And to be honest with you, all that means is I'm just working, you know? And I'm fat. And speaking of that, I don't want that no more, you know? I don't want that no more. I don't want that. I don't want nobody to ever think that they could disrespect me
and call me fat in my face ever again, you know? I don't care if you're being subtle about it. I don't care if you're joking around. Don't disrespect me. And that's just something that I'm getting tired of, you know? People disrespecting you on an undertone level, you know? And it's like, nigga, you ain't gotta be around me. None of you niggas ain't gotta ever be around me. You don't ever gotta talk to me. However, if you disrespected me, then it's only right though that I just not talk to you. I ain't gotta talk to nobody. And I'm just at that point in my life where I ain't gotta talk to nobody. People make the world go round. If you get hurt, you get hurt. You get back up and just keep going. Doesn't matter what happened when you fell. It's just about you getting up and just doing what you gotta do. And by all means, that's what I'm doing. So should you, and you know, keep killing it. I don't know if anyone told you that recently, but yo, you're doing your thing, you're dope, and keep being fly, you feel me? Keep being great, keep doing what you're doing. People see you, I see you, and yeah, I think it's time for me to close out. My kids gotta come down and eat. One project. Oh, they can come down.